Hello friend, in today's lectures we are going to discuss about the simply supported beam when subjected to point load, uniform distributed load and uniform varying load and its shear force calculations and bending moment calculation. Let's see the numericals. In this numericals, 30 Newton per meter UDL is acting, 100 Newton point load is acting and UVL is acting of the span of C to D having the 40 Newton per meter. So in that case, RA and RB are the reactions at point A and B is the reactions at point B respectively. So before solving that, we will see the concept of that UVL again. When the UVL is acting on the span, so total load of the UVL is nothing but it is the total area of that triangle. So in that case, just I am explaining in separately here 40, 0 to 40. So in that case, base is 3 meter and its height we consider 40. So total load of that area is equal to, we may say 1/2, base is 3 meter and height we may consider 40. So in that manner, so we will see total load is 60 Newton load is acting by UVL, but this load is acting from the apex 2/3 L and from this base, from that point C, which is L by 3. So according to that 2/3 L, this distance become 2 meter, this distance become 1 meter. So according to that, here I am marking these dimensions. This dimension is 2 meter and this side, this dimension 1 meter. So we may say this is the centroid of that triangular of UVL. Now let's see its reactions. To calculate its reactions, first we have to apply summation Fy is equal to 0. It means upward forces is equal to downward forces. So RA plus RB both are the upward forces and downward forces. UDL 30 Newton per meter means 30 into 3, that becomes UDL, plus point load is given 100 Newton, plus UVL, total UVL rate you may consider this 1/2, 3 into 40, yeah, which is we already calculated 60 Newton. So RA plus RB is equal to 250, say equation number 1. RA plus RB is equal to 250, say equation number 1. Now we have to calculate the value of this RA and RB. You may take the moments about point A or you may take moments about point B and equate with the 0. Now I am taking the moment, summation of moment about point A is equal to 0. It means I am going to calculate moment from right hand side to left side. So first force is RB into its distance up to the point A is 9 meter minus, just I am taking this first UDL 30, its span is 3 meter and it is acting at the center of that span, means 3/2. So 30 into 3, it becomes a load and it is acting at the center of this span. So that becomes here 1.5 meter, this becomes 1.5 meters, minus point load is 100, its distance up to the point A is 3 meter, next is UVL, load is 60, we already calculated this 60, it acting at distance 2 meter from the point D and total distance become, you may write here 2 plus 5 instead of writing the 7, here you will get the value of RB. So RB is equal to 95 Newton. So RB is equal to 95 Newton. Put this value in equation number 1 here, you will get the value of RA. So RA is equal to 155 Newton. Now next step is calculate BM calculations, sorry, shear force calculations So to calculate the shear force, first we have to decide its sign conventions: downward force positive, upward force negative. So according to that, shear force at point B is equal to, it is going upward side sign convention, so minus 95 newton. After that, up to the point C, shear force at point C, there is no load between the point B and C, so again we may write 95 newton. Between the point C and D, shear force between point C and D, because UVL is acting between the point C and D, so minus 95, load of that UVL we already calculated 60, so 60, it becomes minus 35 newton. Then shear force at point D, again we may write minus 35 newton. Between the point D and E, there is no load, but at point E, 100 newton force is acting, so shear force at point E is equal to minus 35, 100 is coming in downward side, so sign convention positive, so 65 newton. And shear force between the point E and A, because UDL is acting between the point E and A, 65 plus UDL rate is 30, span is 3 meter. So this becomes 155 newton. So shear force at point A is equal to, we can write 155 newton. And if we have to ask here, shear force at the left side 155 minus this, again 155. So minus here, you may say shear force at point just left side of point A is equal to 0. Okay, now plot is shear force diagram. This diagram, shear force at point B is minus 95, at point C minus 95, there is no load between the point B and C, so there is a horizontal line. Between the point C and D, it becomes 35 minus 35, UVL is acting, UVL is there, so we have to show by second degree curve, parabolic curve. Between the point D and E, again there is no load, so again it becomes a horizontal line, so minus 35, but at point E, 100 newton is added, so this becomes here 65 newton, and between the point A and E, it is 155. So this diagram, upper side positive, this diagram negative. This complete shear force diagram SFD. Now move to the next point, that is bending moment diagram. So to calculate the bending moment, first we have to decide its sign conventions. So for that bending moment diagram, downward force we are considering negative, upward force positive, upward force positive, and at the end point, means bending moment at point A is equal to bending moment at point B is equal to 0. Now come to the point, bending moment at point C. I am considering the right hand side because we are going from right to left. So bending moment at point C is equal to, RB is going upward side, so positive, RB is distance up to the point C is 1. So is equal to 95 into 1, 95 newton meter. Now next point is D. Bending moment at point D is equal to RB into its distance 4 minus this load of this UVL, which is 60, we already calculated, and it lies at this center C. So its distance up to the point D is 2. So put the value of RB here, 95 into 4 minus 60 into 2. You will get here 260 newton meter bending moment at point D. Move to the point next, E. that is moment at point E. So first force is our RB into it distance up to the point E, which is 6 minus uvial rate is 60, and it distance this 2 plus 2 4, so this becomes 330 newton meter. Now plot this bending moment diagram. Bending moment at point B is 0, at point A bending moment is 0, at point C bending moment is 95, which is positive value, so we are marking at the upper side. Bending moment at point D, which is 260 newton meter. Bending moment at point E, which is 330 newton meter. So between the point A and E there is a UDL, so we have to join by curvature. E and D there is no load, so we have to join by inclined line. Then between C and D there is a UVL, so we have to join by parabolic curve. And lastly inclined line, because there is no load. So this complete positive bending moment diagram. This complete positive bending moment diagram. Is it right? So here total load is equal to 1/2, its base is 3 meter and this 20, so it becomes 30 newton. If I say the calculations, 30 newton is the load of this UVL, which is acting at point C, which is the centroid point, and this dimension is, we may say, 2/3 into L, total L is 3 meter, so it becomes 2 meter and remaining is 1 meter. So according to that, here I am plotting the dimensions. This dimension is 2 meter and remaining dimension again here 1 meter. Now we will calculate its reactions RA and RB. So to calculate the reactions RA and RB, summation Fy is equal to 0. So we may write here RA plus RB, upward forces is equal to downward forces. RA plus RB is equal to, first I am considering this point load 10 into its span is 1.5 plus point load 10 plus UVL. We already calculated this, total UVL is 30 newton. So this becomes RA plus RB is equal to 55 newton, say equation number 1. Now we have to calculate the, take the moments about point A or moment about point B and equate with 0. So summation moment about the point A and equate with the 0, it means I am calculating the moments from right hand side to left side. So first force is RB. Its distance up to the point A is 5 meter minus UDL rate is 10 into 1.5. It is acting at the center of this, so 1.5 by 2 minus 10. Its distance up to the point A is 2. Now consider this UVL, total load of UVL is 30. It is acting at this point, so distance from that point is this 2 meter and this 2 meter. It becomes 4 is equal to 0. So you will get the value of RB, which is RB is equal to 30.25 newton. Put this value in equation number 1, you will get the value of RA, and RA is equal to 24.75 newton. Now next step is shear force calculations. So to calculate the shear force, we have to consider always first sign conventions, that is we consider downward force positive, upward force negative. So according to that, first force is shear force, at point B is equal to, it is acting in upward side, so sign convention will be minus the, what is the value of RB? RB is equal to 30.25 and RA is equal to 24.75. So here this value minus 30.25 Newton. Now here UVL is acting between the point B and D, so we have to write shear force between the point B and D is equal to minus 30.25 plus 13, that is the rate of UVL or load of UVL, and it becomes minus 0.25 Newton. So shear force at point D, shear force at point D minus 0.25, and 10 Newton is acting at the point D, so it becomes 9.75 Newton. This value is positive. Now between the point D and C there is no load, so we may directly write shear force at point C is equal to 9.75 Newton. Between the point C and A there is again UDL, so we have to write shear force between the point C and A is equal to 9.75 plus UDL rate is given 10, its span is 1.5, so this becomes 24.75 Newton. So all values we already calculated. Now it's a time to plot this shear force diagram. So this shear force, this 30.25, that is the negative value at point D, between the point minus 0.25 there is a UVL, so we have to join by parabolic curve. At point D 10 Newton force is acting and it becomes 9.75. between point D and C there is no load, again we have to write 9.75. between the point C and A it becomes 24.75, or you may say shear force at point A is 24.75, which is just right of point A. So this complete positive, this minus, so shear force diagram is completed. Now let's see bending moment calculations. So for the bending moment calculations, we are going to decide its sign conventions. Downward force we are considering negative, upward force we are considering positive, upward force positive. Now bending moment at point A is equal to 0, bending moment at point B is equal to 0. Always remember these things. If moment will not be occur at the end support, then bending moment at point end support are always 0. Now come to the points D. We are going from right to left. So bending moment at point D is equal to, RB is 30.25, this force RB into these dimensions we have to consider 3 into 3, it means RB, this is the value of RB into 3, minus UVL, UVL we already calculated 30, or you may say again you may calculate 1/2 into length is 3, this 20, or instead of this you may directly write 13, which is acting at a distance of 2 meter. So this answer is 30.75 Newton meter. Now next point is C. Calculate the moments at point C. You may say RB, its distance up to the point E, which is 3.5, this 3 meter into 0.5, minus यू वी एल यू में डायरेक्टली राइट और अदरवाइज बाय फार्मूले अगेन यू में कैलकुलेट इट्स. दिस बिकम्स ए यू वी एल रेट इन टू इट डिस्टेंस 2 प्लस 0.5 2.5 एंड फॉर पॉइंट लोड -10 इन टू इट डिस्टेंस अप टू द पॉइंट सी विच इज 0.5 मीटर. पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ आर बी हियर 30.25 देन यू विल गेट एंसर्स 25.875 न्यूटन मीटर. नाउ वी हैव टू प्लॉट इट्स बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम. ओके नाउ एट पॉइंट बी बेंडिंग मोमेंट इज 0, एट पॉइंट ए बेंडिंग मोमेंट इज 0, एट पॉइंट डी बेंडिंग मोमेंट इज 30.75 एंड एट पॉइंट सी विच इज 25.875. एट पॉइंट सी बिटवीन द पॉइंट ए एंड सी यूडीएल इज एक्टिंग सो देर इज अ पैराबोलिक कर्व. सी एंड डी देर इज नो लोड सो वी हैव टू जॉइन बाय इंक्लाइंड लाइन एंड अगेन हियर यूवीएल इज एक्टिंग सो अगेन हियर पैराबोलिक कर्व. दिस इज द पॉजिटिव बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस टू न्यूमेरिकल्स एंड कंसेप्ट ऑफ यूडीएल एंड यूवीएल एंड पॉइंट लोड when combined act on the beam and how to draw its shear force diagram and bending moment diagram.